So now let's go take a look at some code using those conditional statements and our if statements. So if we take a look at this code here, this is the code I'm using to calculate the tax rates in Canada. And as I mentioned, in Canada, you don't pay tax on an item unless it costs at least $1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask a user, how much did they pay? Then I'm going to convert that to a number, thinking back to what we learned about data types and working with numbers. We want to treat this as a number, but the input statement always returns strings. So I'm just converting that price into a number here. And then I'm just going to say, if that price is over a dollar, then the tax is 0.07, so 7%. And then I'm just going to print the tax rate on the screen. So let's see what happens if we actually try to run that code. And we're going to do call Python, and we're going to call check tax. And if we pass in a price of $20, which is definitely more than $1, we should see a tax rate of 0.07. And sure enough, it comes back, tax rate is 0.07. Whereas if we enter a tax, if I paid 50 cents for something, you'll notice it does not come back and print anything out at all, because both these two statements are indented. So neither of these statements is executed unless the condition is true. So they have these four spaces. That's how Python knows which lines to execute when the condition is true, that indentation. Now, we can add an else statement to this. So I might want to say, if the price is under a dollar, then let's not charge any tax. So I've just added some logic here, exactly the same code, but all I've done is said otherwise with an else statement. And there's that colon. Don't forget the colon at the end of your else statement, at the end of your if statement. I'm forever forgetting that. It's one of my most common syntax errors. Then otherwise, the tax equals zero. So now, if I run this code, we'll just clear the screen, start up again, Python add else.py. And how much did I pay? If I paid $50, then the tax rate comes back as 0.07, so that's correct. And if I go ahead and I run it and I pay 50 cents, it comes back and says the tax rate is zero. Now this is a little cleaner, a little more elegant, because I've got a tax value that's set according to any possible input. Now, one of the other things I mentioned is that if you wish, one of the different ways you could do this is I could write this code exactly the same by simply taking the print statement, because printing the tax rate, I always want to print the tax rate, regardless of what the tax is. The only thing that changes is what I assign the tax rate to. So in my if statement, I say, if the price is over a dollar, set the tax rate to 7%. If the price is under a dollar, set the tax to zero. And then, regardless of what the final tax rate was, print that on the screen. So by taking this out of the if statement and it's not indented, that means this statement will be executed all the time, no matter what happens in the if statement. So now when I run this code, and now I enter $50, you'll still see exactly the same output. Tax rate is 7%. If I enter a price of 25 cents, you'll see tax rate comes out as zero. So the same thing's happening in my code, I'm just using a different way to achieve it. Now, there's one other example I wanted to do, and that was showing you the case sensitivity. Right now, I have a little line of code here that says, please enter the name of your home country, and if the country is Canada, then you must like hockey. Hey, I'm hockey geek girl on Twitter for a reason. I am a Canadian. I love my hockey. I fit the stereotype. Otherwise, we say, okay, you're not from Canada. So if I run this code, comparing strings is the name of my file, enter the name of my country, and I enter Canada. As long as I entered all lowercase, it says, great, so you must like hockey. And I'm like, yes, you are right, Python, I do. But if I run it and I happen to enter uppercase letters, then it comes back and says I'm not from Canada. So this is a case where I have to remember that in Python, when you're comparing two strings, they're not equal to each other if one has uppercase letters and one has lowercase letters. So what I can do is I can take the value that was passed in, convert that to lowercase, and then that returns a lowercase version of what I typed in, which will match the lowercase string Canada. So now, even if I type in, whoops, I need to save that file, that would help. Just correct that. Just realize I hadn't actually hit save, using Control S to save. Now when I run it and I enter Canada, even if I enter all uppercase letters, it still comes back and recognizes that I am from Canada, so I must like hockey. So there you have it. Now let's move on and look at some more complicated situations we can deal with in conditions.